and major cities throughout the United States.
You're watching Game Show Network.
What is your name, please?
My name is Father Umberto Almazan.
My name is Father Umberto Almazan.
My name is Father Umberto Almazan.
Only one of these gentlemen is the real Father Umberto Almazan. The other two are imposters and will try to fool this panel. Tom Poston, Peggy Cass, Orson Bean, and Kitty Carlisle on to Tell the Truth. This portion of To Tell the Truth is brought to you by Clairol, creators of the exciting natural look in beauty.
I have the cleanest and the nicest smelling bathroom in the neighborhood.
Since I put Vanish Hangings in, I actually haven't gone back to clean it.
I haven't seen any stains.
The dispenser is the key item.
It's easy to maintain. That's what it is. It's easy to maintain.
Drop the tablet into the dispenser, hang it on your tank, and just flush.
The Vanish Hangings repels the stains. There's no ring.
Vanish Hangings Stain Repel. Stop stains before they start. S.C. Johnson Wax.
It's still working.
If anybody doesn't believe me, ring my doorbell and you can smell my toilet.
There are lots of dryer sheets. Discover Downy Dryer Sheets with Downy Care.
Take the best care of it. That's the way you love it.
Add Downy's fabric care to the dryer. Downy Care.
Only Downy does it.
Come on in.
Your touch. Scientists call it touch therapy. Try it with Vicks Vapor Rub. Our medicated vapors ease congestion and calm coughing. Touch therapy, Vicks Vapor Rub. Cold relief with the touch of your hand.
My name is Marjorie. I'm 65 and on Medicare. I use insulin to control my diabetes, and I'm low on my diabetic testing supplies. I should be driving to the drugstore now, but I'm not. Medicare covers my supplies, and I could be filling out these forms now, but I'm not. I could be paying out of pocket for all my daily testing supplies, but I'm not. Thanks again. Liberty Medical does it all for me.
If you're on Medicare and use insulin to control your diabetes, call Liberty Medical. Get free home delivery of your diabetic testing supplies with the cost billed directly to Medicare. You'll have no upfront out-of-pocket expense, no inconvenient trips to the drugstore, no forms to file. Your satisfaction's guaranteed.
I could be just a little pressed for time and cash, but I'm not.
For more information on home delivery, call Liberty Medical, 1-800-986-4422. You'll save time and money.
And now here's our host on To Tell the Truth, Bud Collier.
Thank you very much. Welcome once again to Tell the Truth. Good afternoon, panel.
Hi, Bud.
Ah, glowing lot if I ever saw them. Today we're going to try a little experiment. We selected a jury of 12 persons to act as representatives of our entire studio audience. And these 12 persons will have a chance to cast one vote as a jury each time we play a game on To Tell the Truth. The foreman of the jury today is Mr. Bob McFarland. Mr. Bob McFarland, is your jury ready?
Yes, it is, Bud.
Thank you. Then ask them to please stay alert and follow along. And in front of you, panel, as usual, are your envelopes. You've not seen the contents thereof, but open up number one now and follow along with me. I, Father Umberto Almazan, am a Catholic priest in the Order of the Missionaries of the Holy Apostles. To prepare myself to enter the order, I studied theology and paid for my studies by working at such jobs as a floor scrubber and truck driver. Actually, I wouldn't have had to work at all if I had not previously given away all of my money to the poor. This was money I had earned as one of the leading movie and television stars of Mexico, with 200 TV shows and 21 movies to my credit. I appeared with such well-known stars as Anna Magnani, Ingrid Bergman, and Sophia Loren. I hope I'll be as good a priest as I was a movie star, since my former career culminated in my winning Mexico's Academy Award. Signed, Father Umberto Almazan. We start the questioning with Peggy Cass. Peggy?
Boy, I'm so impressed. Number three, when did you quit the movies?
8 years ago.
That you, and number one, did you go to the seminary?
Number
did
one.
You, yes, I do.
You did go to a seminary.
Yes.
Number two, have you taken your final vows? I mean, are you a...
I have.
You have? Number three, what movie did you appear in with Ingrid Bergman?
In The Golden Coach.
The Golden Coach? Thank you. Number one, have your movies been shown in this country?
Yes, they do.
Number two, what is the Academy Award in Mexico?
Ariel is the name.
Ariel?
Ariel.
I'm not so hot in Spanish. But, number three, didn't all your friends think you were crazy?
Yes.
That's what I figured.
Orson Bean.
Number one, did you also appear with Ingrid Bergman in The Golden Coach?
Yes.
Number two, did you?
No, I didn't.
Number two, again, now, what's the name of the great comedy star in Mexico who only has one name?
Cantinflas.
Yes. Number one, do you know Cantinflas? Have you ever met him?
Yes, I do.
Now, he gives a lot of his money to the poor also, doesn't he?
Yes, he does.
Number three, what made you make this decision?
To fulfill my life.
Well, what was missing as a big movie star?
There was something missing.
Yeah? Have you found it?
I think so.
Number three, are you sure? All right. Sure.
Kitty Carlisle. Oh,
number one, when did you get the call and how did it come to you?
It was 1955 when I met Father Bacelli, which is the Pope Pius XII.
Yes, I see. Number two, were you a comedian or a leading man?
I was making characterization roles always, different in each film.
Thank you. Number three, where does Dolores del Rio live?
In San Antonio.
Number one, what picture did you make with Sophia Loren?
I make a couple of pictures with Sophia Loren. One of them was Trad de Blanc.
Thank you.
Tom Poston.
Thank you. Number three, where did you learn to drive a truck?
In my home.
What is your... Oh.
Mexico.
I know, but I mean, did you learn to drive? Did you have your family have property, you mean?
My family hasn't property.
Thank you. Number two, how come you say it wasn't The Golden Coach? What movie did you win an Academy Award for?
For The Young Juarez in Mexico City.
Young Juarez. And number one, did you work in The Golden Coach with whom?
With Sophia Loren.
Thank you. Number three, do you think you would be glad to do this over again?
No.
How would you go about it the next time?
I would know.
You wouldn't know? I wouldn't know either, number three.
And I guess that's all, isn't it? Yeah, that's better. I wondered where that extra bell was. All right, that's it. So please mark your ballots, if you will, please, without change or consultation. And while you're voting, panel, it's time for the studio audience, jury, to vote. Members of the jury, are you ready? Then mark your ballots and select number one, number two, or number three. And after you have voted, please pass your ballots along to your foreman. All right, we'll find out how you voted in a minute, but first let's see how our panel voted. Tom, for whom did you vote?
I voted for number three. It doesn't seem particularly likely, but then neither do the other two.
Peggy Cass.
Well, I almost voted for three because he seems to me like a priest, but I voted for number two because he seems to me like an actor.
Orson.
Well, Father, I wish you luck. This lot looks like the jury that convicted Dr. Shepherd. I don't think you got a chance. I voted for number two because I saw the good father in The Golden Coach, and Anna Magnani was his leading lady in that. Not Ingrid Bergman, as three said, and one seemed to agree with, although he later changed it to Sophie Loren. Not bad, no matter how you look at it.
Kitty Carlisle.
I voted for number two because I have the feeling that he is very happy in what he's now doing, and I believe that he was playing character roles, doing them terribly well, and is now very happy as a priest.
Very well, panel, your votes are all in. Let's find out who got the most votes from our studio audience jury. Mr. Foreman, have you reached a verdict?
Yes, Mr. Collier, we have.
And what is your verdict?
Number three got two votes, number two got five votes, and number one got five votes.
Ah, so we have a tie, a hung jury between the two. Very well, now it's time to find out which of these three gentlemen in truth is the movie star turned priest. Will the real Father Umberto Almazan please stand up.
Thank you, sir.
Father Almazan has brought along some pages from his scrapbook, and I have some of his pictures here showing various characterizations that he performed, so I'm going to ask him to tell us about them. Father, I'll show you, then I'll show the
Yes. There I was a gypsy in the net for Rank Films in London in 1951, directed by Anthony Asquith.
That was on The Late Show recently, and I saw that,
oh,
too.
Oh, no, really?
And what was this one?
This was a Mexican picture. I was playing with Pedro Armendariz, Pancho Villa. I was the secretary of Pancho Villa.
And this one?
This one was the one that gave me the Academy Award.
Benito Juarez.
This is Benito Juarez, and I play the youth. That is the characterization. Mr. Paul Muni make the suite of this film, and the film is named Juarez.
Yes.
This is the young Juarez, the real
no,
picture.
No, that is Juarez, and the other two are me,
you?
The young Juarez.
Yeah.
I was young then.
Very good.
You still are.
Very good. Well, thank you very much, sir, and much happiness and contentment in the life you've chosen. I know you'll do great good. Number one, what is your real name and what do you really do?
My name is Celestino Tamargo. I work for International Airlines, and I was born in Havana, Cuba.
Thank you, sir. And number three, what is your real name and what do you do?
My name is Israel Chapa. I'm the manager of Fonda La Paloma, Mexican restaurant, and he's 49.
Yes, babe.
Your agent must have dropped dead.
Whom?
Your agent.
She's still my agent.
Oh, yeah.
She gets 10% of the collection.
I am making a film now.
You are?
Yes, about Father Pro's life, and it's an American film.
Oh.
Well, in checking the score this morning, we find that there was one incorrect vote from our panel, and we count the hung jury vote as one incorrect vote, so that's twice $100 for a total of $200, gentlemen. Thank you for being with us. Goodbye, and God bless you.
What's there to do?
Nothing.
Did that yesterday. I miss Wheel of Fortune.
Could I tempt you with a little game com? Games on demand.
Are we allowed to demand?
Wheel of Fortune!
I'd give my right wing!
Casino game!
You win! Casino game!
Ooh, what a touch screen!
How divine.
Arcade classics, Indy 500.
Start your engine.
I hear GameCom.
I'm out of here.
GameCom, the ultimate portable gaming system.
Hey, wait for me.
Smells good.
Pass it down.
It's an indisputable fact that kids love the taste of Campbell's chicken noodle soup.
Good.
Yeah. Now hug it all.
And ever since we added more chicken, there's been even more to love.
Hurry up, I'm hungry.
Which means there's still more to go around.
Hey, I never knew there was chicken in this soup.
Mm. Campbell's makes everything.
Mm-mm, better.
You're watching Game Show Network.
Today in America, husbands and wives will hurt. Children will cry themselves to sleep.
Time and time again.
Teens will look somewhere else for understanding. Parents will feel like they are failing. Today, there will be many problems that could be resolved. The teachings that can change your world haven't changed. They come from Jesus Christ. His teachings can strengthen families, bring greater peace and happiness. You can have a free copy of the King James Version of the Bible when you call this toll-free number. It's a gift without cost or obligation. There are solutions. There is hope. The teachings that can change your world come from Jesus Christ, and they are free for the asking. Call now for your copy of the authorized King James Version of the Bible. It's a gift from the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints.
And now let's meet our next team of challengers.
Mm-hmm.
One of these ladies is a medical doctor who sometimes treats her patients by letting them be stung by a wasp. What is your name, please?
My name is Mary Lovelace. My name is Mary Lovelace.
My name is Mary Lovelace.
We'll learn more about Dr. Mary Lovelace in just...
In clinical studies, a leading pain medicine significantly reduced minor arthritis pain, increasing range of motion and flexibility. You may be surprised. The medicine in these studies wasn't a pill. It was Bengay. And now, when you use Ultra Strength Bengay for your aches and pains, you get the heating power of three pain relievers to help you feel better and move better. Ultra Strength Bengay. Medicine for your moving parts.
The people who make Zantac would like you to know, if you've been taking prescription strength Zantac, you may be able to take Zantac 75 to relieve your tough heartburn. As your doctor can tell you, Zantac 75 contains the same medicine as prescription strength Zantac, and Zantac 75 is available over the counter. Ask your doctor if non-prescription strength Zantac 75 is right for you. Zantac 75.
The brand new limited edition Princess Diana postage stamps are now available. The International Collector Society is offering the only collector set ever issued to commemorate the most elegant lady of our time. Recent Princess Diana auction results indicate that this 9-stamp set will sell out quickly and become one of the most sought after collectibles of all time. Not available at your local post office, you can only get them through this special television offer. The complete set of 9 different stamps is only $9.95. You'll also receive a numbered certificate of authenticity and protective display holder. But that's not all. When you order, you'll get this beautiful limited edition Princess Diana airmail stamp, an $8 value, absolutely free. Remember, you get the complete set of 9 museum quality legal tender Princess Diana postage stamps, certificate of authenticity and display holder, all for $9.95. And when you act now, you'll also receive this stunning Princess Diana airmail stamp, an $8 value, absolutely free. Call toll free now.
Very well, panel, open up your second envelope, please, and follow along. I, Dr. Mary Lovelace, am a physician with a rather unusual medical specialty. I specialize in insect sting allergies, particularly the stings of bees, hornets, and yellow jackets. Thousands of people in the country are allergic to these stings, many to such a degree that one sting from a wasp or hornet can be fatal. More people die each year from insect stings than die of snake bite. I inoculate my highly allergic patients each year with the actual venom. However, the best defense against stinging insects is to stay away from them. Wasps and bees are attracted by sweet fragrances. Remember that when you apply your favorite perfume before going on a summer picnic. Signed, Dr. Mary Lovelace.
This portion of To Tell the Truth was brought to you by Clairol, creators of the exciting natural look in beauty.
Very well, panel. These three ladies, as you heard, all claim to be Dr. Mary Lovelace with an interesting specialty. And jury, since you're going to vote again for the real person, listen carefully. We begin the questioning with Orson B. Orson?
Number 3. Are wasps naturally mean?
No.
Why do they act so mean, number 3? Like, the bee has a bad reputation, undeserved. Isn't that right?
No, sir.
He has a good reputation. Well, number 1, everyone's afraid of bees, but is it or is it not true that if a bee stings you, he leaves his stinger in you and then goes away and slowly expires?
Yes, but your stinger can do a lot of harm that he leaves in you.
But he won't sting you unless he feels that he's in danger, isn't that right?
No.
Because nobody wants to die, number 1, right?
Right.
Number 2, wasps can sting you 100 times and not die, though, right?
No, that's incorrect.
They pass away through the...
Kitty, yes. Carlisle.
Is that really true that bees and wasps, if they sting you, they go off and die?
You're asking number 2?
Number 2?
Yes, that is correct.
It is true. Number 3, we hear an awful lot about allergies these days. What is an allergy? Can you tell me in 2 sentences?
I tell you in 1.
What is it?
It's the person who has acquired an allergic antibody by being exposed to a so-called allergen.
Thank you.
That helps a lot.
There you are, Kitty. That makes the day brighter and clearer.
Yes, it does.
It?
Number 1, tell me in 1 sentence, what's the difference between a hornet and a yellow jacket?
A hornet is a larger wasp, a yellow jacket.
Tom Poston.
All right, number three, how does an allergy to insect stings manifest itself if you're stung?
You can get hives all over, asthma, or go into shock.
Mercy. Number two, how would you suggest a treatment for this by someone who is allergic, who is stung?
Well, it depends on the circumstances.
Well, say for home remedy time.
The best thing is to see a doctor
right
as
away.
Soon as possible.
Okay, number one, allergy needles are different
Peggy
from regular...
Cass, I'm sorry, Tom.
Hey, number two, I have reached the fullness of my years, and I have never been stung by a bee or a yellow jacket or anything. Do you mean to tell me that maybe I'd get stung and I could croak?
And not likely, unless you were stung by numerous bees at one time or wasps.
Well, thank you. Number three, isn't there a little scratch test I could take? I'm scared now. I mean, is there a little test I could take to find out? Stop
yes,
that.
Yes, there are tests.
There are tests.
That's all we have time for. It's time for you now to mark your ballots, panel, so please do so without consultation or change. And jury and our studio audience, again, it's time for you to mark your ballots and select, if you will, at that time, number one, number two, or number three. And after you voted, please pass your ballots along to the foreman once again. Very well, we'll find out how you voted in a minute, but now let's see how the panel voted. Tom, for whom did you vote?
I voted for number three. I don't think wasps lose their stingers. And I thought number three's attitude was great for a physician.
Peggy.
Well, I voted for number three. I thought they were all good. But number three looks like a doctor. And also, she summed it up so clearly in that one sentence about allergies, I'll never forget it. I can't even remember it.
Orson.
Well, I hate wasps. Bees are rather sweet. They work, they make honey. Wasps sit around, they sting you to go home and laugh about it. I voted for number three because she was so succinct.
Huh? Kitty.
I voted for number two for a very simple reason. Number two said, if anything's wrong with you, go see a doctor. And that's what doctors always say. They don't like home remedies.
Very well, we'll see how our jury voted and meet the real Dr. Mary Lovelace in a minute. Now, listen to this message.
It's fun for the whole family.
Hey, have a ball with Game Show Network. It's a family affair right here on Game Show Network.
Don't miss it.
The secret is out. It's the best thing on TV.
Baloo was singing to Mowgli the simple bear necessities.
Look for the bear necessities, the simple bear necessities. Forget about your worries and your strife.
Yeehaw!
I mean the bear necessities are Mother Nature's recipes that bring the bear necessities of life.
Yeah, man!
Walt Disney's The Jungle Book, coming to video October 14th.
I'm the best bleach.
I'm the best bleach.
I get rid of tough stains.
I get rid of tough stains.
I get rid of dingy gray film.
I get rid of dingy gray film, too.
I brighten.
So do I. And I work on colors.
Say, how do you do that?
Clorox 2 Color Safe Bleach does what Clorox Bleach does on whites, but it's buffered to do it safely on colors.
Every color?
Red, blue, green, stripes.
Clorox 2 Color Safe Bleach. The Clorox Bleach for colors.
I know these are disturbing pictures, but if all you feel is pity, then I ask you, please don't watch this message. Hello, I'm Angela Lansbury for ChildReach. For just $22 a month, just 72 cents a day, you can become a ChildReach sponsor and not only personally touch the life of a needy boy or girl overseas, but also help the child's family and community achieve goals they set for themselves. For just $22 a month, a little girl like this will never feel the agony of dysentery from dirty water. A child like this will be able to go to school to learn and grow. And this community will strengthen through self-help programs that really make a difference. I'm so glad you've watched, but now that you have, what are you going to do?
Here's the best thing you can do for a needy child, family, and community overseas. Call ChildReach at this number right now.
So, panel, your votes are all in. Kitty voted for number two, and the rest of you all voted for number three. So now let's see how our studio audience jury made out. Mr. Foreman, have you reached a verdict?
Yes, Bud, we have.
And how did your jury vote?
Number two, no votes. Number one, one vote. Number three, 11 votes.
That means, of course, the jury voted for number three. Now, we'll find out which of these three ladies, in truth, is the physician. Will the real Dr. Mary Lovelace please stand up? Thank you very much. All three of them had memorized a solid definition.
Same definition.
And you just happened to ask Dr. Lovelace.
Really?
Number one, what is your real name and what do you really do?
My name is Pauline Rush Evans, and I'm a book editor in Richfield, Connecticut.
And number two, what is your real name and what do you do?
My name is Catherine Fulcher, and I'm a switchboard operator in an apartment house in Manhattan.
Thank you. Checking the score, we find one incorrect vote, but that's worth at least $100 to you. And we do thank you very much for gracing our show, and I hope you had as good a time as you gave us. Goodbye, and God bless you. We'll be back to our show in just a minute, but first, let's listen to this very important message.
You may not understand everything that comes out of his mouth, but with Sunny Delight, at least you understand what goes in it. To him, it's good. To you, it's good for him. What's not to understand? Sunny Delight, the good stuff kids go for.
Are you tired of playing Twister with messy rope, tape, and twist ties? Then you need the Handy Bundler, the world's first endless tie-wrap dispenser. No matter what the size, Handy Bundler tightens to a perfect fit every time. It's lightweight, fits comfortably in your hand, and secures anything as easy as one, two, three. No more tangled rope, messy twist ties, and sticky tape. Now neatly wrap cable and TV wires for a better appearance. Tie garbage bags tight in seconds. Secure luggage to the car for safe travel. Look, ordinary tie wraps just aren't long enough, but the Handy Bundler's cord extends to any size. Large or small, it wraps them all. It's perfect to clean up newspapers, wrap audio and speaker wires, take Handy Bundler outdoors to support tomato plants, train ivy, or bundle an out-of-control garden hose. Keep one in your car for roadside repairs. You can even protect children from dangerous places. Take Handy Bundler to work to tame the wildest computer cables. Secure boxes for shipping. The Handy Bundler is ideal for crafts. Make your own dried flowers. Neatly store holiday lights. Decorate for any festive occasion. And the Handy Bundler is virtually indestructible. Even the law can use Handy Bundler to detain criminals. You'll find hundreds of uses for the Handy Bundler around the shop, at home, in the office, and on the job. Now, in this limited time offer, you get the Handy Bundler. Over 50 feet of durable nylon strapping that'll hold just about anything. And 100 locking clips, all for only $19.95. And it comes with this guarantee. Use Handy Bundler, and if you're not convinced it's the best tool ever, return it for a full refund of the purchase price. Order now.
Have your credit card ready and call 1-800-593-9779 or send $19.95 plus $5.95 shipping to Handy Bundler, P.O. Box 2987, Framingham, Massachusetts. For faster delivery, call 1-800-593-9779.
You're watching Game Show Network. Next up, it's Password, followed by Tattletales, then blast off to Game World.
That's all we have time for today. Goodbye, panel. See you tomorrow. See you tomorrow, too. In the meantime, don't you forget to tell the truth.
To Tell the Truth is a Mark Woodson, Bill Totman production. Johnny Olson speaking. Today's program is pre-recorded.